Hi! In this video, I'm going to show you how to extract the images from the PIC files created by Hikvision cameras. Since my last video, Hikvision has changed the way the information about the file's capture date and time is stored and accessed. That is why some of you had trouble extracting the images using the Perl script from my second video and were forced to use the Python script method from my first one. The Python script still works perfectly for extracting the images, but it's not able to use the capture date and time when naming them. So you should use it only as the last resort. The Perl script I'll be using in this video improves on the last one and will work for both old and new Hikvision cameras, so this method should be your first choice. The first thing you have to do to run the Perl script is install Strawberry Perl. In my last video I've recommended ActiveState Perl. Strawberry Perl is much better, so if you have ActiveState Perl installed, please uninstall it and install Strawberry Perl. You can find the link to Strawberry Perl in the video description. If your operating system is 64-bit, download the 64-bit version, otherwise get the 32-bit one. I have already downloaded the 64-bit version, so I'm gonna close the browser and install it. The script requires some additional Perl modules to be installed. They should come bundled with Strawberry Perl, but let's check that anyway. Click on Start, type cpan, and then click the cpan client. Type the following command and press Enter. It will check if the required modules are present, and if they are not, it will install them. As you can see in my case, they are installed and up to date, so I'll type exit to close the cpan client. Create an empty txt file and name it extract_capture.txt. Right-click on it and choose Edit. Now you need to copy the Perl script's code from my GitHub page. Again, you can find the link in the video description. Select all the code, then right-click and choose Copy. Paste the code in the text editor and save it, then close the text editor. Right-click the txt file and choose Rename, then change the file's extension from txt to pl. Click Yes to confirm the change. Now I'll talk a bit about the file structure the cameras use. In these two folders, I have file samples from two different Hikvision cameras. The ones on the left are from an older generation camera, and the ones on the right are from a newer one. Depending on the size of your camera's memory card or hard drive, you could have one or more DataDir folders. As you can see, both use the same .pic files to store the images, but the older camera stores the capture date and time in a file called index00p.bin. The newer camera uses SQLite to store them in a database file named event_db_index. This doesn't actually depend on the age of the camera, but on the firmware version is running. The index01p.bin file is just a backup copy of index00p.bin. Their contents are the same, so the Perl script will use either one. On the new generation cameras, the two index files are different. As you can see, event_db_index00 has a slightly larger size and the internal structure differs a bit. The Perl script will only use event_db_index01. As a side note, I will have to warn you that for a limited time during the transition to the new way of storing the information, Hikvision used PicDBIndex instead of EventDBIndex. Since I didn't have any samples to see if the internal structure of that file is the same as the one of EventDBIndex, the script will not work with PicDBIndex files. So if you have a camera that uses PicDBIndex, please leave a comment and it would be great if you could share that file with me so I can update the script. The file doesn't contain images or other personal information. Now I'll create the destination folder where the extracted images will be placed. Open the command prompt and change the path to where the extractCapture.pl script is. In my case, it's on the desktop, so I'll just have to change the directory to desktop. I'll first extract the images captured by the older camera. Now enter the command that runs the script. Type extract_capture.pl, then press space, and after that, enter the source directory path. The source directory should be the directory that contains the datadir subfolders. Make sure to place the path between double quotes. One more thing, make sure the camera is not accessing the files while you do this. This could happen if the camera stores the files on a network attached storage. If that's your case, turn the camera off before running the script. Now press space again and enter the destination directory path. In my case, the destination directory is the JPEG folder. Again, make sure to place the path between double quotes. Now press enter to run the script. This dialog will pop up. This only happens on the first run. Click where it says Perl Interpreter. Check the box to always use this app to open .pl files and press OK. Now you need to run the command again. Press the up arrow on your keyboard to bring back the command so you don't have to type it again. Then press enter. I want to extract all the images, so this time I will not use a date and time limit. I'll enter 1 to use the first naming format. This is a new option that wasn't available in the old Perl script. The camera can save 2 or more images in the same 1 second time frame. Since you can't have 2 or more files with the same name, the script can either keep only the first image and ignore the rest, or rename the others. So if you enter 2, only the first of those images that have the same name will be extracted. If you enter 1, the script will rename the others to be able to extract all of them. I'll choose 1, but this file sample doesn't contain any time duplicates. You'll understand this better when I extract the images from the newer camera. I'll now delete these images and run the script again to extract the images created by the newer camera. I'll enter the same command, only now I'll change the source folder to the one where the newer camera files are stored. As you can see, the script renames the time duplicates and adds a number at the end of the file name before the dot. Now I'll do one more image extraction to test the date and time limit option. For this test, I'll use the date and time values from the names of the already extracted images to make sure the values are within the available time interval and I get a result. As you can see, the script extracted only the images that were captured during the specified time frame. And that is all. Leave a comment to let me know if this has helped you, or if you encounter any problems. Thanks for watching.